Alright everybody, today I'm going to teach you how to create a thumbnail using DaVinci Resolve. And it's going to look something similar to this when we get done. So anyways, to get started, let's go ahead. I'm going to use whatever photo you want for this. I'm going to be using the picture I have picked out already. And drag it in, drop it. Now from here, we're going to go ahead and use a text. And drag it in, bring up our inspector, and if it's not open, you can go up here and click it and bring it up. So for this, I'm going to type in DaVinci Resolve. I'm going to choose our font. You can use whatever you want. I personally like the Open Sans Lite. Now that we have that, we're going to go down here. We're going to position it where we want it. And again, this is personal preference. This is just how I'm setting this one up. So we're going to bring it down something kind of like that. Now we're going to bring in another text from the effects. And also, since I didn't show you, if that's not up, you can come up here to the effects tab. Bam, and that's right there. So for this one, I type in tutorial, considering this is a DaVinci Resolve tutorial. I'm going to use the same font. Now here, we're going to go to the position, and we're just going to position it where we want it. Just move this down below. So now we're going to have something, you know, similar to that. Again, yours will be different, but, you know, just kind of judge and place where you want it. Okay, so from here, we're going to have our main text to catch people's eyes, and this one will have a background. So, for this, I'm going to type in how to create. And since we want this one to catch people's eyes, I'm still going to use Open Sans, but I'm going to use regular Open Sans and change it to bold. Now from here, I'm going to go down to zoom and I'll make this one quite a bit bigger. Now we also want to position it something kind of like that. Come down here to our background tab in the inspector. And you want to use something that contrasts with the color of your picture. So for this, since it's purple, I'm going to use a blue. It goes good with the purple, I think. So we're going to do the color and the outline color. From here, you want to start with your height. Get it kind of where you want it. And bring your width in or out, however you prefer to have it. Also with the corner radius, I prefer mine to have hard edges, so we're going to bring that down. And for the opacity, we're going to bring this up to about 68. Alright, so we got the first main border done. Let's go ahead and drag in one more text. Now for this one, we're just going to type in a thumbnail. And we're going to do the same thing. We're going to use Open Sans. And we're going to make it bold. So now we're starting to get somewhere. Let's go down here to our background again. We're going to change the color and outline color to the same blue. Or whatever color you choose depending on the thumbnail that you make. This is just kind of a general overview to show you how I make them. Okay, so now we're going to bring our height up and bring our width in. Let's go up here and maybe zoom this just a little more. Something kind of like that. All right, so we're going to bring the width back in. Sharpen out our corner lines. Now, if you don't remember what you set it to, you can come back. And here we have it 68. So we're going to type this in, 68. That way they match. Now, to move it, bring in this line right here. We're just going to bring the y-axis up just a little bit, and doing it from there, it'll move all of it together so you don't have to mess with the border and then the lettering. Alright, so now we've just about got this done. I personally like using some kind of a PNG file, like an arrow or something, kind of grab attention. And you want to place this on the very top. So now we have this in. Going to bring the zoom down a little bit. Rotate this around. And let's start positioning it. Bring the zoom down some more. And yeah, just a little more. Bring this position over. And now we can zoom it out just a little. So there you go, something similar to that. I don't know. Now, one big key factor of doing this, you've got to be able to export it. And this wasn't something that was explained to me. I had to do a lot of digging for it. But you're going to come over here to your color tab. Just like that. And now in here, we have a keyboard shortcut that we're going to use. It's going to be Control, Alt, and G. As you see, it brings it up here to the gallery. And if it don't pop up, hit your LUTs and then come back over to gallery and it'll show. Now from here, you want to right click, go to export. Wherever you save them to, I have a folder specifically for thumbnails. Right here, you want to make sure that it's a JPEG or a PNG, and then just going to rename it. Just like that. And then you're going to hit export. And from there, you're pretty much done. I hope that this tutorial has helped everybody. If it has, I'd love for you to hit a like. It definitely helps a small channel. And if you enjoy the content and the rest of the content on the channel, definitely consider subscribing. I hope y'all enjoyed it and hope to see you on the next one.